How's it going, guys? I hope you've had an amazing, amazing day so far. I'm kind of getting used to that now. It's kind of my little, I suppose, intro thing. I feel like every YouTuber has their sort of intro. I suppose that's mine. So yeah. Today, we're going to be chatting about confidence and how I feel that there are three main things that have resulted in me becoming a more confident person. You know, that guy that walks around all the time in his boxes at the start of pretty much every single video, Instagram, TikTok, wherever you want to find it, every single video. So for me, I think there are three main things that have leveled up my confidence. And today we're going to be running through them. And just to let you know, number three is definitely the most important, so make sure to stick around until then if you want to become the most confident version of yourself. And also, whilst you're here, and if you enjoy the video, don't forget to hit subscribe. Over half of the people that have watched these videos so far are not subscribed yet, so make sure to hit that button. And if you really enjoy the video, make sure to hit that like button as well. Point number one, stepping out of your comfort zone. Now, this is something I make an absolutely huge deal of all the time. And something recently that I feel like I've done quite a bit, I touched on it in my first ever YouTube video, sort of a couple of weeks ago now. And for me, stepping out of your comfort zone is huge. Me going into YouTube, it was a big step out of my comfort zone, but I've decided to do it because I feel like it's allowed me to grow as a person. It's allowed me to develop. Personal development is something you always hear me talk about, guys, and genuinely stepping out of your comfort zone is one of the most amazing things that is going to happen to you. Genuinely, it's going to increase your confidence a huge amount. I can almost guarantee that. Now, sort of some examples of stepping out of your comfort zone. Say, for example, you are the kind of person that is going to the gym maybe for a few weeks, maybe a few months now, or is really, really new to the gym, and you've just started off with sort of those machine-based movements, maybe a few cable exercises, maybe predominantly bodyweight exercises. The next step for you to step out of your comfort zone is trying to go in that free weight section. Finding exercises online that you think are going to work for you and trying that out. Another way you can step out of your comfort zone, especially when it comes to the diet side of things, is trying out new meals. Using apps like MyFitnessPal, like I talked about in the last video. Trying out new foods that you've never tried before. Trying out new recipes that you think you'll enjoy. Stepping out of your comfort zone, expanding your knowledge, trying these new things, it's going to make everything so much easier for you. You're going to begin to trust yourself a little bit more. And for me, stepping out of your comfort zone is a huge indicator that you're becoming a more confident person. Point number two, no longer fearing failure. Stepping out of your comfort zone was obviously point number one. Step number two is sort of almost linked to this, and it's also linked to what I touched on in point number one, in trusting yourself. Self-confidence for me is derived from trusting yourself. If you trust yourself that you're going to learn from the back of failures, if you understand that failing isn't the be-all and end-all, you are going to become a much more confident person. And the reason behind that is because you'll try things and you won't worry about the outcome too much. You'll understand that failing's a part of the process. I've failed countless times. I've been through so many sort of obstacles in my life, and overcoming those obstacles, because you learn off the back of them, because you learn so much about yourself, what kind of person you are, how you react in certain situations, how you can make a positive spin on these situations, is so important when it comes to becoming a more confident person, in my opinion. Don't worry about failing, because you can always learn off the back of those failures. And I believe that learning off the back of those failures is a huge thing, and I'll sort of explain why in point number three. When I reach out my hand to touch you, I add in something for me, cause you move when I get close. But oh, I hate that bright blue, it's going in this dark room. You turn away like I'm not here at all. Genuinely, I think becoming a more confident person completely changed my life. You guys always, always hear me talk about how I'm living the dream, how I absolutely love what I do, how it's my favorite thing in the world. genuinely my biggest passion and the thing I absolutely love doing the most. My biggest hobby is content creation, helping you guys, helping my coaching clients. I am in a position now where I'm living the absolute dream, as I said, and the only reason I'm able to do that is because of me building up confidence, because of me becoming a more confident person. If I didn't begin to step out of my comfort zone, if I didn't learn not to fear failure, and if I didn't do point number three, which you're going to hear about in a minute, I wouldn't be the confident person that I am now, and I wouldn't be in the position I am now where I feel like I've got more freedom than ever and more fulfillment than ever. So we could be alone now. Can't you just be here when the lights go out? Why don't you ever put that phone down? What could be so goddamn? So point number three, I sort of touched on at the end of point number two that you need to learn off the back of your failures. You need to learn about yourself. And for me, the most important thing when it comes to becoming a confident person, and definitely the thing that completely changed my confidence, completely leveled up my confidence, is working on my insecurities. Now, this is something I probably will touch on in a future video. It's probably a little bit deep this early into YouTube, but it's going to be something that will genuinely be life-changing for you. Sort of understanding your insecurities, understanding the things that you need to work on, and becoming a more confident person off the back of that. I've been through so many previous things that I needed to work on. I wasn't as secure a person as I sort of thought, and self-reflection, learning about my insecurities, picking certain things that I felt I could improve on was an absolutely huge step for me in the right direction when it comes to improving my confidence. And I have a little challenge for you guys. It's completely up to you whether you do this, no sort of pressure from my end to go through with this. If you don't feel like it helped, no worries at all. But genuinely, I think if you do this one thing, or three things that I'm going to mention in a second, you are going to, in probably quite a short period of time, depending on how much you sort of invest into it, I think you'll find your confidence start to blow up. Now, what that sort of task is, what this thing that I want to set up for you guys is, I want you to pick three insecurities. So do a little bit of soul searching. Think about what you feel you need to improve on. Think about how you can work on yourself. Look into personal development. Look into self-improvement. Pick three things. Really nail down on these things over sort of the next few days, weeks, months, and see if you can improve on them. So for example, with me, and again, I'll touch on this in a later video, my three insecurities when I was at quite a low point, the three things that I thought I needed to work on. First things first, my acne. I've still got acne now. You will see in some of my clips that I've still got back acne. I've still got little bits of face acne. But working on this, having a better skincare routine, eating a healthier diet, exercising more outside, getting more fresh air. These things have genuinely helped improve my acne, which used to be a huge insecurity of mine. And for me, it's not anymore. And I'm more confident in my appearance. Now, obviously, also, the point of this series is summer shredding. It's losing body fat. If you feel like you're in a position where you either want to lose body fat, where you want to gain muscle, and obviously, I want to teach you guys how to do that as well. This could be an insecurity of yours. This could be something you feel like you need to work on. And definitely something that can improve your confidence, not only sort of over the long period, but in a short period, because if you make active steps to do this, you're going to feel so much better about yourself. Something else that I worked on, the second point, was working harder. So previously, I felt like I wasn't working hard enough. I was maybe laying in a little bit too much. I was maybe stopping work a little bit too early. Working harder on my craft, working harder on my business, it's paid off in the long run. And I'm in a much happier, more confident position because of this now. Point number three was to do with money. So I felt like I wasn't earning enough money. I felt like I wasn't doing my absolute best to earn what I felt like I could. And for me, money isn't just about sort of those material things. It's about the freedom that comes along with it. And earning more money gave me that freedom. It gave me more of a chance to work on myself in sort of other areas of my life and step out of my comfort zone, which I'm doing now. See, the three things are linked. Stepping out of your comfort zone is linked to no longer fear and failure. No longer fear and failure is linked to working on yourself, working on your insecurities. I feel like all three of these things go hand in hand. So if you really act on one, hopefully you can act on all three. So guys, it's time for us to get to work. It's time for us to really nail down on what we feel like we can do to become more confident people. I've certainly still got big steps to make. I've got so many things I want to achieve over the next year, and that requires more confidence. It requires me investing in myself even more. focusing on personal development and self-improvement. And hopefully, off the back of this video, you guys know what you need to do to become the best version of you and improve your confidence. As per usual, if you enjoyed the video and you got this far, make sure to hit the like button, make sure to hit subscribe and turn on the notification bell. Have an amazing rest of your day. Big love. H.